2 weeks before Taliban forces marched into Kabul, a former U.S. Army interpreter managed to get his mother and two siblings out of Afghanistan. But as this report tells us, one of his sisters is still in Kabul, and he vows to do what he can to bring her to safety.
Hamadullah Ihsan is a former Afghan interpreter for the U.S. Army living in California. And he says he's prepared to do whatever it takes to get his sister out of Taliban-controlled Kabul, where she remains with her husband and infant child. Just one of the many Afghans who fear the Taliban will return to the harsh version of Islamic law enforced while when the group was last in power 20 years ago.
All I just want her to be safe out from out there. The Taliban, as I told you, they've never been changed. I cannot compare them to the animal. Animal is much better than them. I cannot compare them to any human being in the planet. They are more dangerous than anyone you think of that.
He says he saw what was coming and got his mother and two siblings out of Afghanistan just weeks before the Taliban marched into Kabul. They are now registered with the United Nations Refugee Agency in neighboring Tajikistan. He says he's put his sister on an evacuation list, but she hasn't been called by the U.S. government to go to the airport. Ihsan worked with multiple army units in Kandahar from 2008 to 2012. He's been in California since 2015 on a special immigrant visa. In addition to his sister's safety and human rights, he fears reprisals against others like him that worked with the West, despite the Taliban's reassurances.
I have a lot of their videos. They're knocking people door, asking for interpreter, asking for people that they're in the military, asking for all those people, and they're going to kill them. If I would be there now, of course they're gonna find me and they're gonna do something, but thanks God I'm here.
In their first news conference after taking Kabul, the Taliban said women would be allowed to work and study within the framework of Islam.
U.S. President Joe Biden tells Washington's allies America is on track to meet its August 31st deadline of pulling out its troops from Kabul. But he also ordered the Pentagon and State Department to come up with contingency plans. He adds the success of the evacuations will highly depend on the cooperation of the Taliban.
There are real and significant challenges that we also have to take into consideration. The longer we stay, starting with the acute and growing risk of an attack by a terrorist group known as ISIS-K, an ISIS affiliate in Afghanistan, which is a sworn enemy of the Taliban as well. Every day we're on the ground is another day we know that ISIS-K is seeking to target the airport and attack both U.S. and allied forces and innocent civilians.
Biden also says the legitimacy of any future Afghan government will depend on the Taliban's approach in preventing the country from becoming a base of terrorism.
The G7 leaders and the leaders of the EU, NATO, and the UN all agreed that we will stand united in our approach to the Taliban. And we agreed that none of us are going to take the Taliban's word for it. We'll judge them by their actions. And we'll stay in close coordination on any steps that we take moving forward in response to the Taliban's behavior.
As the frantic Western evacuation operations in Kabul pick up pace, the Taliban says they will no longer allow Afghans to go to the airport. They are urging locals to stay to help rebuild the country. The group also warned the U.S. must stick to its August 31st deadline of withdrawing all of its troops from Afghanistan.